to make for this one, group 1 and group 16, and then group 1 and group 15. So in group 1 we take sodium, in group 15 we take nitrogen. So 1 minute to make it. Okay, let's check. So sodium, our dear fellow, has 1 electron. Oxygen has 6 electrons. So if 1 electron goes from here to here, the octet of oxygen is not yet fulfilled. So
one more Na.
Yeah, we would need one more Na. So
Na2O.
Exactly. And then we have group 1 sodium, again 1, okay, and then nitrogen has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if 1 electron goes here, I would need 2 more electrons to complete the octet. So I'll take 2 more.
So-
yes. What happened? Coughing?
Yeah, actually yesterday I had like a cold drink. My mom actually told me not to drink it, but I was like, eh, nothing's gonna happen. And now I'm facing the repercussions.
So my mom must be looking at you and saying, Bola tha na, bola tha.
Yes, the whole
thing. Now let's take a look at group 2. Okay, and group 17, group 2, group 16, group 2 and group 15. Okay, so calcium, let's take calcium. Group 17 mein let's take chlorine, calcium with oxygen, calcium with nitrogen. Okay, first your turn, and then in 2 minutes we'll do it. So aapka Ca 2. And we would require 2 chlorines because the formula is a CaCl2. Now, to do the formula also, if you know the periodic table, it becomes very, 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 very easy. So 1 electron goes here, 1 electron comes here. So Ca becomes 2 positive and there are 2 chloride ions. So it becomes
CaCl2.
Right. Now, Ca, again, 2 electrons. And oxygen is 6 electrons. Out here it will be just a CaO because both the electrons go to the oxygen out here, and it becomes a Ca 2 positive, O 2 negative, so CaO.
Yeah, CaO.
And in the last one, we would require 3 calciums. Okay, and I'm just. Yes. So I'm just switching off my video for a while, okay?
Okay.
Now, so Ca and N and an N. So Ca 2, 2, 2 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 3 electrons go here. 1, 2, 3, octet complete. 1, 2, 3, octet complete. 3 Ca2 positives, 2N3 negative becomes a Ca3N2. Okay. Now, the last step, you know, we can take is our group 13. Group 13 with group 17. Group 13 with group 16. And group 13 with group 15. So 13, let's take aluminium with bromine, aluminium with oxygen, aluminium with nitrogen. Okay, first your chance.
First one, AlBr3.
Yes.
The second one, Al2O3.
Yes.
And ALN.
ALN. And while making it, that means aluminium, group 13 means 3 electrons, would require 3 bromines, group 17 means 7 electrons. So, you know, when the basics are clear, it becomes so easy to do all these things. So we go here, one electron here, octet complete, octet complete, octet complete. And then Al2O3, 2Al with 3 electrons each because they are in group 13. Oxygen belonging to group 16 has 6 electrons, and we need 3 oxygens out here and one more. Okay. But in class 11th, you'll learn that octet rule is not the whole and sole rule. There are many elements, many compounds which do not follow the octet rule, yet they are stable.
Okay.
And then we have, I'll show you one, Abhi. Okay. So we have an Al with a 3 and nitrogen with a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the electron goes here and here and here. So AlN. Now this is the basic of our ionic or electrovalent bond. Now the next major type of bond is our covalent bond. Now covalent bond, in junior classes, we talk about being formed between a non-metal and a non-metal. But when we come to senior classes, basically when there is less electronegativity difference, okay? When there is less electronegativity difference, transfer of electrons cannot take place. Okay? They cannot, because both of them have nearly the same electronegativity. And if they have nearly the same electronegativity, both of them are pulling the electrons with the same force. And if they are pulling the electrons with the same force, the electron is not going to go anywhere. So to form the bond, they share their electrons. Okay? For example, if I look at hydrogen, hydrogen forms a diatomic gas.
Covalent bonding.
Yeah, covalent bonding. So here it is like this. Now, generally in covalent bond, we show it with the help of circles. So inside the circle, we can see that there are two electrons. So after sharing the electron, this hydrogen also has two electrons, and this hydrogen also has two electrons. Please don't use maths here, sir. 2 plus 2, 4 ho gaya. Theek hai na? There will be many people who say, you know, there are many students who say, sir, aapne idhar bhi 2 likh diya, idhar bhi 2 likh diya, 4 ho gaya, lekin dikh to 2 hi raha hai. It is sharing. Okay. And sharing se kya hua? Sharing se unka helium ka noble gas configuration is completed. That is why it is stable. Now, if you look at let's say the chlorine gas, group 17. So when we look at chlorine gas, chlorine, one, it behaves as a diatomic gas. So when it is a diatomic gas, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Again, out here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So out here also, we'll see what has happened is, after sharing one electron each, both of them have gained the octet. Okay. Now let's go over to group 16, the oxygen gas, O2. Now in O2, oxygen has 6 electrons in the outermost shell, and this oxygen also has 6 electrons in the outermost shell. So 6 plus 2, meaning they are going to share 2 electrons each. So if I show it in the form of circles in the middle, so out here, and there are 2 lone pairs on each oxygen. So if we make the circle out here, 2 lone pairs, 2 bond pairs or shared pairs, and 2 lone pairs, 2 shared pairs here also. Take it?
Yeah.
Then if we look at, let's take a look at, let's move to group 15. Group 15, nitrogen gas. Now, when we make the nitrogen gas, again, is the same thing. Group 15 means it has 5 electrons in the outermost shell. So it needs 3 more. Since it needs 3 more, it is going to share 3 electrons. So 3 electrons are going to be shared. So what has happened is we have a nitrogen here with a lone pair. 3 electrons have gone in the sharing, 3 electrons on this side also in the sharing, and 1 lone pair. So if we look at each nitrogen, they have 1 lone pair and 3 bond pairs, 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pair, and the octet is complete. Okay.
Yeah.
Now these type of molecules will be non-polar. This will also be non-polar. Okay. The next one will also be non-polar, because both of them are the same elements. Same elements means same electronegativity. Same electronegativity means the pull of the electrons is equal. So there will be no charge on any of the atom. But if I have a compound like HCl, now H has one electron in the outermost shell, Cl has 7 electrons in the outermost shell. So by sharing of electrons, the hydrogen has gained 2 electrons and the chlorine has gained 8 electrons. Okay. But chlorine is more electronegative. So the electrons that should have stayed in the middle does not stay in the middle. It gets pulled partially towards chlorine, partially, not completely. That is why chlorine gets a partial negative charge and hydrogen gets a partial positive charge. These type of molecules are known as polar molecules, where there is a partial negative charge and a partial positive charge. Okay? Now let's take an example wherein, you know, the molecule is non-polar but the bonds are polar. Let's take a look at carbon dioxide. Now if I look at carbon dioxide, the 4 carbons of electrons are shared with two of our oxygens. So it comes like this, and oxygen has 2 lone pairs and 2 lone pairs this side. Now if we make a circle, check here, 8 electrons.
Yeah.
The next circle of the carbon, 8 electrons. Okay. Yeah. The next oxygen, 8 electrons. Okay. So what has happened is, carbon has formed a double bond with oxygen here and a double bond with oxygen here. Now, oxygen is more electronegative. It is more electronegative. In fact, it is the second most electronegative element of the periodic table. So it is going to pull the electron density towards itself. Oxygen is going to become delta negative, partially negative, partial positive. Likewise out here also, this is going to be partially negatively charged, partially positive charged. But now if we look at a vector, if we look at the vectors, 2 equal vectors in the opposite direction is going to give us 0. So the bonds are polar, but the molecule, the dipole moment of the molecule will be 0, because both of them are going to do what? Cancel each other out. Okay? Up, let's look at, so we did normal covalent bonds, okay? Then we did the covalent bonds between 2 different elements, giving our charges, polarity of charges. Then we had the bonds that are polar, but the molecule is non-polar. Now let's look at what I said, ki octet complete nahi hai, phir bhi stable hai. Boron belongs to group 13, 3 electrons in the outermost shell. It forms bond with 3 fluorines. So fluorine number 1, fluorine belonging to group 17 has 7 electrons in the outermost shell. And it shares out here. And then we have another fluorine out here, sharing the electron out here. Now, each of the fluorine, see, octet complete. This fluorine, octet complete, octet complete. But can we say the same thing about boron? How many electrons are there in boron after the sharing? Only
six.
Yeah, but yet it is stable. Now these kinds of substances will be known as Lewis acid. They'll be known as which acid?
Lewis acid.
Because they basically become electron acceptors. Now let's see, how are they going to accept the electron? Okay. Now looking at my ammonia, okay, is I cannot say if it is acidic or basic, cannot say. But what can ammonia do? For this kind of a thing, what do we need to look at is the octet of nitrogen complete? Check.
It is, yeah.
Yeah, it is. Okay. Does it have a lone pair of electrons?
Yeah.
So what it can do is, it can share its lone pair of electrons with boron trifluoride. Now this fellow has become an electron donor. Okay. And an electron donor is a Lewis base. Okay. Now, do you know how ammonium hydroxide is formed?
No, so in that case, nitrogen is an electron acceptor or an electron donor?
Not nitrogen. Ammonia is an electron donor.
Okay.
And this type of a bond is known as a coordinate bond. It is a type of a covalent bond only. But in covalent bond, one electron came from this side, the other electron came from this side to form the bond. In the coordinate bond, both the electrons come from one side.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yeah.
अब इसमें आपके पास अब क्या आएगा? ये हो गया coordinate bond. Okay. Now, अब देखते how is ammonia a base? We say it is a base. We say that when we add water to it, it gives a hydroxide. Let's look at it. ये ammonia है, okay, NH3. Okay, so here we go, NH3. Now, what does this fellow do is, इस वाटर में से इट पुल्स द H प्लस टुवर्ड्स इट. ठीक है. नाउ डज H प्लस हैव एनी इलेक्ट्रॉन? H प्लस इज बेसिकली व्हाट?
इट्स अ प्रोटॉन.
इट्स अ प्रोटॉन. इट डज नॉट हैव एनी इलेक्ट्रॉन.
या.
सो इट फॉर्म्स अ कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड. Now, when it forms a coordinate bond, this fellow becomes NH4 positive. Ab water mein se H positive is gone. What is left of water?
Oxygen.
OH negative. Theek hai. So the OH negative. Now see, in this example, what do we have? In this example, we have a covalent bond. ठीक है? We have a coordinate bond. ठीक है? And we also have an ionic bond. So all the three bonds are present out here in the form of covalent, coordinate, and ionic bond.
Okay.
ठीक है? Okay, so this is also clear?
Yeah.
Now let's look at the shapes. Okay, for the shapes, I will teach like this. If there is an element A and it forms two bonds, It will always be a linear molecule. ठीक है, इफ इट इज AB3 मीन्स ए फॉर्मिंग थ्री बॉन्ड्स, देन इट इज एक्चुअली फॉर्मिंग अ ट्राइगोनल प्लेनर स्ट्रक्चर, मीनिंग बिटवीन द बॉन्ड्स द एंगल विल ऑलवेज बी 120 डिग्रीज,
Right.
बट इंस्टेड ऑफ वन बॉन्ड देर इज अ लोन पेयर. So we have an A with a bond and a lone pair. The lone pair is not forming a bond, so it is not going to come in the structure. So it will be a bent structure. ठीक है? Now we come to the next one. The next one is an AB4. AB4 can make two types of structures. One, it can form four bonds like this, and it is a tetrahedral structure, which is the main structure. But in some of the cases, A can form bonds like this in the diagonal. So if we join this one like this, it forms a square structure, and it is also known as a square planar. ठीक है? Now we'll concentrate on only the tetrahedral for the time being. Now, if instead of four bonds, it has one lone pair, so A is going to form three bonds, but there is one lone pair. So it is going to form a trigonal pyramidal structure. And by chance, if it loses two, it has only two bonds and two lone pairs. Again, two bonds and two lone pairs would mean the lone pairs do not contribute to the structure, so it becomes a bent structure. ठीक है जी? Now let's look at AB5. AB5 means there are five bonds. So A, B, 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 B. So I can make a pyramid on top and I can make a pyramid at the bottom also. So it is basically a trigonal bipyramidal structure. ठीक है? Now, instead of one bond, there is a lone pair, AB4L. So what happens is, one of the bonds becomes the lone pair, and we have a bond here, bond here, bond here, bond here. It forms a seesaw structure. You just need to rotate it. If you rotate it, it will look like a seesaw. Then, if there are three bonds and two lone pairs, so the lone pair comes here, lone pair comes here, a bond, another bond. This is a T shape. ठीक है? Then, if we go to AB6. So we have an AB6 means we have an A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. On the plane, we have a square. And a pyramid is being formed at the top, and a pyramid is being formed at the bottom. So this is known as octahedral. And if there is one lone pair, it is if it becomes AB5L. So A के पास लोन पेयर, 1 bond, 2 bond, 3 bond, 4 bond, 5 bond. Now this basically forms a square pyramidal structure. Square ke upar pyramid, so it forms a square pyramid. And the last one that we look at is if there are two lone pairs. So we have an A with a lone pair, B, 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 B. So we have what? We'll have a square planar structure.
Yeah.
Take care. So these are the types of structures that we can have. Now, in the next class, I'll touch these also. SP, SP3, SP2. Have we done SP3 and all? No, I don't think so we have done. No. So we will stick to this one only. And okay. And we will complete the shapes we have done. Sigma and no, there is beta. S and P, sigma and pi is there. Matlab S and P is there. Okay. We'll do the sigma and pi bonds in the next class. Metallic bond. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Chalo then. Enjoy.
Okay then, bye sir. Thank
bye
you.
Bye.
Oh, sir,
so Bolo na.
Wednesday ko, what's the time for Wednesday? It's same, right?